Is it possible to die and then come back to life? We've heard of a few experiences, and here is one of our own mom, Prosimulinde, who went to heaven and then came back right here on earth. She's sharing her experience, what she saw in heaven and what happened there. You don't want to miss this because it's very, very important. If you're new here, please.
Like, comment, share, and subscribe.
Are you done? Yes, I'm waiting for you. Subscribe. That red button. Subscribe. Are you done? All right. Thank you very much. And now, let's dive right into the video.
Before I got saved, I used to love the same people. But for me, I wouldn't get saved. But I would never criticize them. And in one way or another, I used to feel that they are part of me. And I used to promise that later on in my life, I'll give my life to the Lord. Whenever I'll meet brethren preaching on the streets and in the marketplaces, I wouldn't criticize them. And I felt that those people belong to me. But time came when I felt that it was high time for me to get saved. Nobody witnessed to me the gospel, but I just felt the conviction of the Holy Spirit. And time came when the Lord himself put the song which says that when Jesus comes, where will he find you? During that time, I used to live in my sister's home. And my sister's ready, it's up to you. So that same evening I went, I would get saved people. I told them I have come to get saved. I have come that to pray for me and to salvation. That same day, I took the Lord to be my personal Lord and Savior. But I used to hear some people say that when you get saved, you feel as if you are so light, just floating in the air, a burden is taken away from your life.
And so,
once I had confessed, I just started exercising myself to have that kind of experience of floating, just like
that.
Although I could not physically float, but I felt peace. And I felt joy inside of me. A lot of joy. And I said, surely am I saved? And soon as I got saved, I really desire to serve the Lord. My prayer used to be to the Lord, that Lord, I want so much to be your servant, I also want to go on shouting in the streets. Although I was very shy, but I just desired to go and shout like the
Balokole
do. And time came, the Lord paved the way for me. And he showed me a local church where I should be. And when I had only been there for a short time, they called upon people who desire to become missionaries. And I also registered that I go. My pastor wanted to hinder me, but I really cried a lot of tears. And later on, he allowed me and I joined the team going to Luwero. But I didn't even know how to open the Bible. And when they would say Genesis, I would open Revelation. And yet I was intending to go and preach. Later on, there was a sister who was much older in the spirit. She used to ask us that you people, when we go to the crusade ground, you must testify. You have to give your testimonies. You know, I used to hear people say, I committed reckless sins, but I personally, I have not committed such great sins. So when we were asked to give testimonies, I started actually, you know, putting together a testimony, because at least I wanted to say something that would touch people. Because I started searching my life, my past, that I didn't even have a disease. A big disease in my life. And yet later on, I remembered that I had something that bothers many women. It's a kind of demon. In Uganda, it is called Kigalanga.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And when I would go to my monthly period, I would feel a lot of pain, and then they told me that you were bothered by a demon called Kigalanga.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And so, when I went to give my testimony, I said that I was bothered and troubled by a demon called Kigalanga, and the Lord delivered me. Why don't you come and get saved?
You
too. But I was so full of fear, I couldn't even speak for long, because all the words I had put together to speak, they even disappeared from me because of fear. You know, I was always panicking, and I felt fear. After I had given a short testimony, I would go outside and say, but I left out this one, that one, because I was always panicking when testifying. But putting all that aside, I used to have that cry. It was always my heart's cry, because when I looked at the Bible, the men and women of old who really were great in God, I used to wonder how they became great for God. And time came when I started desiring prayer so much, because they had told me that the secret lies in prayer.
What was the song when I interrupted and yes, Manuva Wadi and Bamitam Chalan Cindy Rose?
There is a sister here, Mrs. Cindy Rose. I don't know whether it was
Ambula and Gay and Etuno Yamukama and Etuba Mubi Talk and Etusiva and Etusalanga Tuangala Kufukanga Days of God.
That is the sister we were always seeking God together with, moving together and seeking God. We wanted to become like Daisy Osborne. And we used to sit together after we had prayed and would converse. And I just want to go to nations preaching and ministering. That's
all.
I felt that, you know, I loved God so much besides everything else. Although that woman I desired was a married woman. And both of us, me and the other sister, was always confessing like that. Time came as we were seeking God in such a serious heart.
I want to meet any Uganda. You must be put track to track.
I'm cutting it short because I want to get to the point.
Akasera kotekali kamunya kokuno nyamukama twaita mbintu byali bindi nyeriali byangu byali tuze mabego butano nyamukama.
It was a really tough moment, the time of seeking God, because we went through so many rough experiences that were hindering us to seek the Lord.
Omulungi gwange gwe nasokera ddala okulya ku ddoboozi lya Katonda.
And my very first time to hear the voice of God,
twali tutambulanga tulina twali tugenda kunona mmere kugireeta nga naye tulina ebintu bye twemulugunyako ebimu ebitulemesezza bye tusanze.
We were going somewhere to pick some food and bring it where we used to stay, but we went grumbling and complaining because we were going through certain rough experiences. And we were complaining to God, saying, but Lord, don't you see this? Don't you see this? Can't you see this?
Mukisere cho nagelo kula ngampuri edobozi ya yogena na katisiza kuganti java novawani. Nena uri angandi wakati mudobozi gingeri vude muta yudingeri vude weru wangi.
So that was the time when I felt a voice that was encompassing me. I didn't know where the voice was coming from, but it spoke right from my spirit, my heart. And I had never heard the Lord speak ever since I was born. And the voice says that, said that the word of the Lord is a hammer that breaks rocks into pieces. And when I heard that voice, I looked everywhere. And my friend was moving ahead of me, and I told her, sister, something has happened. And I told her, just keep quiet. God is going to break us into pieces. And I told her that God has said that his word is like a hammer that breaks into pieces, which means going to break us into pieces. And so we went and dug out the cassava from where we went to pick it, took it home, we went and hid somewhere, and we were crying to God to forgive us and to have mercy upon us. And then later on we went and approached our group leader. And we shared with her that as we were going to pick the food, we had a voice saying that he's going to break us into pieces. Please pray with us that God will not destroy us.
Na yamu sere tu peya chisegele la unaganti yamu yonge de mkisawa mkama joko ungero chibatanga.
But our group leader did not understand what it meant. She just told us that you continue in prayer, the Lord will elaborate.
Na yedo wazi ya koma otegeye yonge.
But the voice never spoke again.
Netugena maso na ukuno nyaka tondorva ni mamkama ya tuwe mirembe kuchonti. Te chari kuruda rafe na yede chari wakati mumbele ketuwa itogela.
And so we continue to seek God, and later on the Lord actually comforted us, and he told us that it was not against us, but it was for the conditions we were going through. And one time, as we sought God in the cassava garden deep down there, we would spend a lot of time, many days, down there in the garden. We really loved God so much. We would praise the Lord, we would worship, we would share the word, we would converse together. And time came, after we had waited upon the Lord for a long time, we felt frustrated. And then we prayed with all our hearts, we travailed and said, Lord, why don't you come to us? As we were still in such a condition, we slumbered a bit. And when we slumbered, I saw the sun. The rising sun, it was red. And a voice spoke in my spirit that the Lord has risen upon you. Rise and
shine.
And then I woke up suddenly and I shared with my sister and we entered into prayer. Something happened because the power of God fell upon us tremendously. And then the Lord later on spoke to us. And then he gave us our
calling.
And then after that he gave us a message for our team. And so we went back when we were feeling so good.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. And then we started saying that, you know, these people look down upon us. But for now, for us, we can hear from God. Surely God has called us. God is going to use us mightily. So we were arrogant, proud about it. So we sat down with the rest of our group and we shared the message with them. And they were all touched and we made a resolution that we seek God together. And then the Lord did not stop there. He came to us another time. Many times the voice of the Lord came to my life. In a great presence of the Lord. I'm not going to continue on that. I'm going to cut it short. And God, time came when God gave me a spirit of knowledge and revelation. And even if it would be in such a big gathering like this, the Lord would reveal to me things about people's lives. I'll prophesy in the future, tell them what was going to happen in the future, whether it would rain, whether someone will come to us, and so on. And time came, many people started joining us because of that gift we had in our midst. And I felt that I had become someone at least. And then I started looking down on others.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And I started feeling that I think there isn't any other one like me in this generation. Time came when the Lord would send us messages in our midst concerning repentance. But for me, I refused to repent. You know, I used to feel that those repenting messages are for the rest of the group because for me, the Lord had called me, He had spoken to me, He could appear to me in great power. So I didn't have any need to repent.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Many things happened during that time. And I would even give the meaning of visions. And sometimes I would get words that were so clear from the Lord. And I felt that I had been raised in a high position. I never wanted to humble myself. Time came when my joy started decreasing in what God has given me. And I did not understand why it was happening like that. But I was just pretending. And I pretended to be all right. No problem with me. If a message would come about repentance, I'll just throw it to the others.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And time came when the Lord started warning us. And the Lord said that without repentance, something terrible will happen in your
life.
All of us had gone astray in one way or another. Each one of us was exalting himself in one way or another. Because God had promised us to go to many nations. And so we just pictured ourselves in those different nations. It was a tough thing to see that we had something which God was against. And God continued sending messages in our midst that if you don't repent, something terrible will happen in your midst. You know, one would examine himself or self, saying that, okay, if something is wrong with me, why is the power of God manifesting itself in my life? Time came when people would come to consult me for counseling and so on. Even if I wouldn't hear from God, I would just tell them my own information. Because I was satisfied that I knew all.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Time came. We were in the midst of prayer. And the Lord came to us in a mighty presence. And he said that if you don't repent, if you don't put things right, trouble will come in your midst. Someone, one of you will be
there
away. There will be tests in your midst. But I for me knew for sure. In a midst there was a brother who was not walking all right. He was walking in crooked ways. And so for me I knew that it was Charles who was going to die.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And
more messages came in and
made it.
You know, you could repent, but you would not genuinely repent. And you would check your heart, and you wouldn't see anything bad. And I would ask God, Lord, check me, but I don't see anything funny. We see
that
I don't see where I have gone astray in my life. But many messages came to us that in amongst you there is pride, there is despising, because I was always despising preachers. And I'll tell the difference between a spiritual man and someone who is not spiritual. And if one would preach a message which I do not desire, I would know that is the one that is not in the
spirit.
Even if my other two friends would be touched by the message, I would set them aside and tell them that I don't feel that is the, you know, appropriate message. But that was concerning me, it was my weakness.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So time came. In the prayer I'm talking about, we started our prayer meeting at around
7:30 p.m.
From 7:30, we came up to 8 p.m. in the night, taking time to repent, but not genuinely. We did not feel that we had any guilt of sin. This is what I remember. That is, after some time, I felt like as if I was slumbering. As if sleep was taking me all of a sudden. And then I felt like shivering in my body.
Go
something, an experience, like someone would put something on you that will make your body to shrink. And you get some kind of rust. So I felt that kind of shock. After that shock, and I saw my life in the air. I was running swiftly, but I did not understand it. And then immediately I realized I was in a strange land. A dry land. And there was things like small hill, anthills, and dry trees.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Light,
and some kind of grace light. And I realized that I was running at high speed and very swift. And then I noticed that from behind me, some people were chasing me, but they were of small size, and they were not actually clear in my sight. They were almost reaching me, and they were left with a little space to reach me. And then all of a sudden, I realized that I had left that area. And then I met a man. Because I noticed that he was a man. He was a man taller than me. And he was putting on glittering clothes. And then he told me that they have told me that I should take you. And so he took my hand. Well, after we had walked a short
distance,
I looked on my side. And I saw green grass. It was green grass up on hills, and you know, it was endless. And there were, you know, among the green grass, there were small trees growing among that
place.
And then I felt in my heart that surely I'm going to take a rest among these trees in the grass. So I wanted to sit on the green
grass
because it was a very good sight and one would enjoy relaxing there. But that man told me that you are not allowed. When he told me that you are not allowed, then I started seeing myself that surely I'm not worthy. And I was feeling it that at least I was, you know, almost getting to the
worthy.
So just after a short time, when we were still going through those
fields,
we came to a place where there were flowers on every side. And then my heart was so
strong
because I saw strange
colors.
And the colors of those flowers were being reflected in the
space.
Oh, and I said, this is wonderful. Wow, I must pick one of the flowers. At least to take a
single.
Because I felt a sweet smell there. Everything was so beautiful. But the angel told me you are not allowed. But I felt that it hit me. But I never wanted to accept it. Immediately when we came out of that area, another angel came. That one was bigger, taller, and was more glorious than the other one.
mikono nye bigere nga bibiri.
After we had just gone about two steps,
ninkiraba bulabi nti tuli ku nguudo eza zaabu.
I just noticed that we were walking on golden streets.
Zonga nungi nyo.
Very beautiful.
Era obanga oluyimiriddeko bw'otyo olaba nga wansi lugenda n'okutangaala naye nga kwa zaabu.
You know, when you would stand by that golden street, you would see that it was so glittering. And you know, the glittering was so deep. And I looked on the side. And you know, the glittering light was actually being reflected. And so I see it continuing.
I stopped.
And then he told me that you should
have
if you fear to take your kingdom, who will take the kingdom? Just walk and we go. And so I continued walking. As we continue to walk, I felt voices singing wonderful voices. They were coming towards us from
afar.
And I felt like feeling happy. Because I was a singer. And I said, oh, it's time for me to sing. They said we shall sing in heaven. I think we are going to that place of singing. So I started, I wanted to start singing. But the singing wouldn't come out. But the voices would touch
many,
many
voices.
Some of which I had never
heard.
They were going up and going down. And nobody had ever been to such a place where the voices were
going up.
And the voices were
going up.
You would hear multitudes of people singing in joy.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And time came,
I felt as if we had just neared the very place where the voices were coming from, but I didn't see those but I felt that the voices were so near
to us.
Just as I had been overtaken by the voices, I felt that we were entering into a kind of a building. It was a very, very gigantic building. And I would look, it was entering. That at this end, it was
empty.
But it was so glittering. And then my heart was overtaken by
it.
But yet inside of me, I was not sure of myself.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And
I would force myself to feel happy, but I wouldn't really feel happy. Time came when we drew near. And I felt that my eyes would no longer see anything else. And my eyes were focusing in one place only. And then I saw fire. The fire was blue color. But it was not burning. When I looked very closely, I saw someone sitting in the middle of the fire. But on his side, there were multitudes of people. But I was not allowed to look and examine those people. And I drew near. The angel was just pushing me forward, but I didn't have the strength to continue. I was not sure of myself, but yet I was confident of myself.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Conviction would come into my life. But I was always confident because I knew I was saved and I was used to God. I've been seeing miracles happening. Another thing I forgot to tell
you,
I did not feel my body. But yet I was feeling I had a body.
And
I would feel as if I was in a body which God I couldn't see. And yet I was even hearing just as you hear with your
people
ears.
I tell you, we have a hidden life inside of us.
The Bible calls it the inner man. That kind of body which is invisible. And yet it is there.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because I would walk, which means that in that kind of life is where the talking comes from.
Box to box,
this is just an outside box to tear. And that inside thing
is the one that
it is the one that enables a human being to move. If it goes away, you can no longer move. You understand that?
Are
you with me?
Hallelujah.
Amen. If you are with me,
work. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so we continued,
and I was focusing on the blue
fire.
And I was focusing on that person in the midst of the fire. As I still looked at him closely, he also lifted his eyes to look at me. I was not very near to him, neither was I so far from him. And then he looked at me with very sorrowful eyes. He looked at me with very sorrowful
eyes.
And then, slowly by slowly, his eyes changed and they appeared like fire which was looking at me. And that kind of sorrow hit me. And I felt like running away from that place. And yet inside of me I was very confused. Because I was saved. And I could see miracles. And they told us that when we were saved, everything of yours is all right. 100% we are going to heaven.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nantunulira.
And so he looked at me.
Nali sisi atola kumutunulira nate.
I could no longer look at him.
Nantunula wansi.
And I looked down.
Nenga ndaba ntumulaba.
And I would still see him.
Nantunula mchitawa masoga waluwe bitawo bibiri.
In front of him there were two books.
Nantunula mchitawo.
And so he looked in
one of them.
And then he looked at me again.
Bantunula naite rinyali yangi.
When he looked at me he called
Amanya
my name.
Bonna.
All my name.
Aboluganda mukama akumani.
I tell you, God knows.
Mukama akumani.
God knows.
Mukama manyeri nyaliyo.
God knows your name.
Alina neri nyaliyama nyomuche naliatamani.
He knows even your name, which nobody knows.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Alineri nyaliyari nyomuche naliatamani.
He has a name which he knows, which nobody has. And it is your name.
Mukama naampita.
And so the Lord called.
Nangama tinakuita.
And he told me,
I called you.
And I called you my friend.
Nenkulonda.
And I chose you.
Nenkunaza.
And I washed you.
Nenkufula omuntu wange.
And I made you my son.
Nakufula nabbi wange.
I made you my prophet.
Era mukwano gwange.
And my friend.
Kati nze bibala.
Now give me the fruit.
Mutisere chaboruganda.
So during that time, brethren,
nagezako kulowoza.
I started thinking.
Nengezako kufuniki.
I started meditating.
Nengeza buli kimicho.
And I thought, I never did it. But whatever
I wanted to do, I wanted to do.
And whatever I wanted to hide, I wanted to
do.
And I
think
I couldn't give
it
any excuse. And then he told me that I gave you that gift of
seeing.
And I gave you the ability to
preach.
And even to teach. But whatever you would mention for each gift, you would demand the fruit. And I didn't see the fruit. And I felt my heart melt. And I looked for a hiding place. And I searched for excuses. And I felt like everything was just running away from me. And I tried to remember all the excuses is about the other people against me. I tell you, I couldn't remember properly. And I felt empty. And I felt very ashamed.
Hallelujah.
And the Lord told me, remember, during such and such a time, I sent you my message. And you understood. And you said it was my message. Give me the fruit from that message. So I started in that time to remember. It was as if someone had removed the curtain from my
life.
And I started looking at my life. And I saw back in the time when I
was there.
And I would see the preachers that time and the messages that time. And the Lord demanded for the fruit. Please say, give me the fruit from
sin.
And I seemed as if a curtain had been removed. I saw my life in the midst of
sin.
Seeing that I was
sick,
and I saw all the pride coming out of me. And he said, give me the fruit. Brethren, let me tell you, if you call it a being, there are so many excuses in this world. There are many things where we hide ourselves. On that day, they will not be there. They will run away from us. There will be no excuses.
Najukira omusajja olugero mukama lwe yatugerera omusajja yayira maaso ga mukama n'anoonya okwekweka ne yeewolereza nga talina kigambo kyonna kyayinza kugenda.
I remembered of a story which was told to us why a man was demanded to give his report before the Lord and the man couldn't say anything.
Emugani kyozza otya wano?
The Lord asked that, how did you come? Without the garment of the party, and the man just
said,
that same thing happened to me. I didn't have anything to say. And whatever I would want to say was
useless.
And I was very ashamed.
Hallelujah. Today
you may give excuses, but on that day you will not be able to give excuses.
Hallelujah.
The Lord showed me so many things concerning my
life.
And he asked me that, you give me the fruit from all the places you made. You used to say, I'm going to love you, I'm going to serve you, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that.
Uganda,
there is a secret here. If God loves you and you do bad before
him,
they will not remember the good things you did. The good things you did will not be remembered. Whenever you commit
before
him, all the good things you have done are wiped away and you go back to zero.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I ask the Lord to give me the grace to continue. Because whenever I remember such a time, I remember that time when I stood before the Lord, and I just feel it once again.
Hallelujah.
I remembered, brethren, all each and every sin I committed. When one comes out of this life, your remembrance still remains. Your memory, that's what I mean. And sometimes I would want to tell the Lord that, Lord, you could also see, but I won't even speak it out. And the Lord continued to mention all the sins I had committed. And I started trembling. I wanted to be swallowed up. And I wanted to turn and let the other person behind me speak on my behalf. But I couldn't even turn. So the Lord took the second book.
he opened it. And whenever he would open, there would come voices of shouting. There would come voices of weeping. He opened about five pages. And every page would open, weeping and crying would come out. Many voices, young
and old,
big and small voices. And I would understand that such were the people I had led to perdition. And then afterwards he said that for every tree that beareth not fruit, now the axe is laid on
the
to cut every such a tree. And he said that for me, I put you there to bear fruit. Give me the fruit. I didn't have any fruit. But he said that.
Mukusoka wetu akayingira nga ouli amalobozi galigena widago kuyimba nga gayingira wano mpola mpola.
By the time we entered in that big place, I would hear the voices of singing coming from afar.
Nanyo mukatera kutewali wo mtuto na okujaka kasiri ilo kumareza kika nani namba.
But by that time he was speaking to me, there was complete silence for about an hour.
Ngaka ulila kintucho nasi nyenye.
And you wouldn't feel anything moving
anyhow.
And nobody would just even turn. And after only 1 minute, the angel told me that let's go.
Nunga munda muze nganchi,
and but just inside of me I felt that, can it be true that they are going to throw me into the lake of fire?
I'm
so we moved and I asked the angel that where are you taking me? And he just said let's go. And so as we went, we bypassed the voices we had heard before. And inside of me I was saying, I was thinking that maybe they were going to give me some whip, just as the Bible says that whoever knows much, a lot will be demanded from that person. And then I felt that maybe they are taking me to a certain place to be whipped by an angel. But I did not realize that they were taking me to the fire. Because I knew I was saved. I'm a servant of the Lord. I know how to speak the mysteries of God. And I would not actually realize that was taking me to a place of torment. Because that's what I was told. And so we got to the other place where they were singing, and I wanted to divert to go there, but the angel said, let's continue.
But I think say uko katono.
After we had gone beyond that,
nenda banga nengere chiwom.
I started seeing a valley.
Ngakiri wala,
it was far off.
But I yongera kutambula na dake yongera mad.
As we continued and I realized we are continuing,
nenda ndiko kulia maloboza gavayo.
I started hearing voices coming from there.
Okusaba nokulekana.
Crying and shouting.
Ngabuli munsi nasaba amazzi munini zonna.
Everybody that was there was asking for water in different languages.
Malaika nankwa se chikube chali ekinini, ekiringa chikube chenge.
And the angel took me through a route, a big way.
Ngakigide bigeregere bingi.
There were many footmarks there.
Ngakiringa nga wali nkube bwetonya nenga. So watonya wo kuba nengo lanti buli alinya we kigere kigalawo.
There were many footmarks.
Ebitono nebinene.
So many footmarks small and big.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And he told me, let's go. And I started feeling I was resisting. And then that was the time when I started feeling this. Because I would see the sight of fire, but it was deep down, I couldn't see
it.
Not a fire from wood, but a fire from coal.
When I didn't have no kugenda.
So as I was resisting to go,
Malaika nansindi kakukatono wazi.
The angel pushed me a bit.
Nangamba genda.
And he said, you go.
Nangamba no.
And I said no.
Amangwa banani negansula negansindi kamazi.
And immediately a power just took me ahead. When I got there, I felt like running backwards. And he continued to tell me, you go, and he was stopping in a certain place. And power lifted me to throw me even beyond that. And I felt like running away, but every time I try to run, I'll feel as if I'm falling into fire. And yet the fire was still far. And I would hear the people shouting, but they were far away. And he told me at that time, go. And that time I jumped a very long distance. And it was not just lifting a small child and you throw it at a distance. That time I felt that I had fallen into fire. Because I didn't want to go, I fell backwards. And when I fell there, I felt as if I had fallen into the fire. And yet the fire was still
there.
But the heat that was coming from there, and there was a lot of hot heat from
the
there was a hot wind blowing, making such a noise.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mukasera.
So during that time, I started feeling fire burning my back. And I felt that I was burned. And I said, let me turn this side which is not burned. And I thought that the Lord would help me. And but I just thought that they are taking me to a place of punishment after whipping me. Just for the injustice, I'll be removed from there. As I was trying to turn the other side, one of the sides was already burned. And so I changed another side. And the other side and the second side were still hot, and I changed another side. And I felt the fire just penetrating inside of me. I tell you this, that terrible thing. And so I changed on another side. And all the sides were burning hot. And yet I had not reached the place of fire. And I could no longer see the angel anymore. And I knew that was the end of me. So I opened my mouth to cry. When I opened my mouth to cry, that heat came and entered into inside of me. And I closed my mouth immediately. And I felt as if I was swallowing I felt as if I was putting a live coal inside of my mouth. So I felt the burning both externally and internally. The Waganda has a saying that says that when I close my lips, I'm burning inside and I'm burning outside. That's what I felt. So I wanted to make another cry before God. When I tried to open my mouth a second time, another heat entered inside of me.
mpulira nti kati mpweddewo nga magumba gonna mpulira nti magumba gayingiddemu omuliro ku ngulu nzija ne munda nzija
and I felt that fire was everywhere inside and outside of me
amanyi ne ganzigwana
so I lost my strength
ningwa ku bigere byange
and I just fell upon my feet I surrendered my life
namugamba nti mukama
I say Lord
osinga omusango bw'osala
I want you to be right here for me.
Ere misango jo jansonga.
And your judgment is right.
Ndikifu gunsi.
Surely I am condemned.
Newaye na yenga newaye byokufa.
And I was surrendered to death.
Nga manyinti kati mkwede nsulidwa mulio mkwede. Ne mukama sigalinga wa mazina.
And I said surely this is the end of me. But Lord you are still right here. You are the one who is right.
Ingwa wansi sikya sobola kwogera sikya sobola kufunya kintu kyonna.
So I just fell on my feet. I could no longer talk. I could no longer do anything.
Kati nga manibu manyanti yemzumu jikena kuno nao jintuari jinkakemo.
And I started thinking that the demons will just come and pick me from there, throw me into the fire.
Nengo yote mpuri ya nchi njimu mulido
already. But I felt that I was already in the fire and yet the fire was not there.
Nikasera ako.
At that time,
yempunye dogo zingaliza wala.
I felt a voice coming from very far.
Ngaliri ngeri jira mu echoes.
And it was like coming into echoes.
Ngamba jangu.
The voice was calling, come.
Ninga sola kusikuka.
But I won't rise up.
Munda nenga ntuba mizimu jeji nsika.
And I felt inside of me. I said, is it demon calling me?
Kani ya mpito genda.
And I thought that it is the devil calling me to
death. Mungi ya guwako vigawo zinaitamu nerika.
And the voice came a second time.
Ama da ingia muhili guwange na nyini ya kumanguru gani.
And I felt some strength and I got up.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Narebe chita maso gamu kama.
I saw the grace of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Edo zinaitamu nerika mungi ya guwako lala.
So the voice called me yet another time.
Ndingana tijangu.
And it said, come.
Ama ni nigamu watu kuni musokuntu. Sakudare ya sendi yewe na sofu. Na sendi okugwa okuva.
So that the power lifted me from the place I was to take me to the my first spot of falling.
Nemala ye mitenda jonesa tu okuita mmanya gaganga kukayela gemanya ganzia ye.
So I went through three steps of falling. As I had it the first time.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nentu kawali malaika.
So I got to the place where I had left the angel.
Nina mbugu jawe.
But I was still hot with the fire.
Nangu watako.
I saw it touching.
Nimbanga echuma jira yeka maze kisalabati.
And you know, there was some kind of noise. The voice which you hear when you pour water on a burning metal.
Nangamba tulabe kitama soka mukama.
And the angel told me that you have received favor before the Lord.
Mukama mwesi wa Uganda.
I give all the glory to God.
Mukama mwesi wa Uganda.
Brethren, I glorify God.
Nalabe kitama soka mukama.
I saw the grace before the Lord. I was just at the brim of the lake of fire.
Nangamba tugende.
And the angel told me, let's go.
Nentambula ngankankana.
And I walked trembling. I would not understand. I was out of my senses.
Ebirungi byonna byonna nga sibira.
And I wouldn't see anything good.
Ningandaba obuvivu n'obuli munsi.
But I just noticed how bad I was.
Ningandaba omwana agiyena kabisa.
And I saw that I was a candidate of hell.
Nankulembera nanziza emusowe nayimiridde okulaba omuliro.
And so he took me back to the place where I stood to see the fire.
Mukama ffe n'antunuulira n'akamwenyumwenyu.
And the Lord looked at me with some kind of smile. For me, I just started shedding tears.
Hallelujah. Amen.
And he said that you have received favor before me. See no more. That nothing greater shall come upon you. But I would not understand what he meant. I was just having a propulsion experience all over. and I was not sure of myself, and I didn't know what was next. And even the grace he was talking about, I would not understand by that time. And then he told me that it is me who chose me
to take out.
And I put you.
Zena kulokola.
I saved
Zena kulita.
I called you.
Zena wawo.
And I put you where you are.
Nivala, nivala, nivala.
To bear fruit and the fruit that will remain.
Nkutoku dayole roba le nivala nivala.
Now I release you today to go back and to bear fruit and the fruit that shall remain.
Nivala, nivala.
When you bear fruit,
kari.
It's okay. But if you don't bear fruit, remember that one day you will come back to this place. You will stand before me and you will give me your accountability. He told me, you go back and tell my people that time is up and I'm coming back soon to reward each and everyone according to their work. But I want fruit. He told me the time is up and I'm going to rise up from my
mother
and there will be no more
mercy
and there will be no more forgiveness, but my people are not ready. My people are doing their own
thing.
They are doing their own
thing.
They are seeking for their own. They are walking in pride. There will be no more mass. And I will not
aid
my eye will not pity anybody. May God have mercy upon the church.
Katonda muliro.
Our God is a fire.
Muliro gwezini.
He's a fire.
Era muliro God.
And he's a consuming fire.
Katonda wakuchusiza kusaidia ndale yobukambwe tekigumikirizika
buluganda. When the Lord turns you his side of fury, it is unbearable.
Nalaba ekiseera ekizibu nga Mukama ankyusirizza embala ye ey'obusungu.
I had a very terrible experience when the Lord turned to me in fury.
Kyasaga leero kikyanyooma leero wali tewali bakunyooma.
That day, we will not have a chance of
disguising.
Whatever we feel we would hide there, it will not be there. The unsaved will not appear before the Lord because for them they are already condemned. It says that if you reject the Son of God, you are already condemned. But for us, we are going to stand before the judgment throne because we were recorded in the Lamb's Book of Life. There is being recorded in the Lamb's Book of Life and there is being removed from there. Because of a reason. Hallelujah. During that time, he showed me some kind of wall clock that was behind
him.
It was not like an ordinary wall clock. But I noticed that it was a wall clock because I would see the hands of the clock. And the hand of the clock was approaching one. karimi ya keda chika sijukila vunji wakai nenga kari once in saa we watch. And the other hand was almost near to the
other one
said that you would be. And he told me
nange nzija mamu
and I'm coming
for kwa wili mchungu mbo mimu gogogwari
to reward every person and to give the reward to everyone.
Aruganda tulindida muka mutuchari.
I tell you we are waiting for the
Lord to visit us. Mbo sabula mbo sabonzari.
But if we don't pass our lives
okujia kwa muka makulizo mutaba sanje tuli
the coming of the Lord may not be joy to us.
Kubanga ya dana nenda kujia kuwole le guanga.
Because he said that I'm coming to repair
vengeance.
Okuwala ne guanga. I'm coming to repair vengeance.
Olabu mwana omu ntu akuwala nande chikuruma na iti katonda kwa akuwala ni.
If a man, if someone is against you, you feel bad. Now what about God?
Hallelujah.
Kamaleo.
I just want to wind up. I want to close. So the Lord said that
Gendo
I have mercy upon you.
Go back and
Gendo bear fruit and the fruit remains. But I'm coming very soon. Tell my church that they get ready. Because I'm coming soon. And my time is up. And tell everyone
to work out
salvation. The salvation of a personal salvation. I tell you these things require
relationships.
Even if you are doing great works for God, but you are having no relationship with Him, it will not benefit you. The good works are not bad. And big works are not bad. But you must work out His works with a
gentle.
And that's the only way we can carry out His will. The major thing is not to be recognized by people, but to be recognized by God. Let people not recognize you, but let God recognize you. Let people not love you, but let God love you. So I was escorted out of that place. And I walked away in trembling. And I feared to go back through that place where there were men chasing me.
Malaika nangama nchitosha.
But the angel told me, fear not. The presence of God is upon your life. Go and bear fruit. And the fruit that shall remain. And then he took me to the place where he had got me from another angel. And the other one also took me by hand. Took me to the place where he had got me from.
Okuvao nenda banga ziramo kuduka speed ya manyonga zikawansi na ningo muntu agwa mu runyo rushagwa yene nga
tesi. So from that place I ran swiftly and I felt as if I was landing into a place which was endless.
Eranda ita mchifee chote wali wachincho nasi ankomago.
And I went through that area and nothing touched me.
Nentuka mchifowe tuwali.
And I got into the place where we had been. I stopped just over a little bit in the air. And I saw all my other companies. And I would see my body somewhere in a corner. It was just a small time, a small moment. And I saw myself going down and my body came to receive me. I found my body in the air.
Hallelujah. Oluganda tuli wano.
Brethren, we are here. We are in a time of getting ready. We're waiting for the coming of the Lord. The Lord who loved us and called us. And he gave you what he gave you for us. And whatever you have done in your life, there is a redemptive purpose for it. If you don't fulfill your redemptive purpose, you will stand before him just as I did. And you have to give an account of your life. I wanted to give excuses, but the excuses vanished from you. Whatever you would like to hide yourself, just as he had that the hills will run away from his side. Even the excuses will run away from
you.
Therefore, nothing shall stand before the presence of the Lord. You will see yourself just as you are. The Lord has promised to visit us. But that God is a fire. He said that I will come into my temple without their knowledge. Because I am like the refiner's fire.
Mumaso de Aruganda, the one that we need a walk, Mutaina Balado Rufunido.
Before the sight of the Lord, no one with spot or wrinkle shall stand.
Again,
the
Futuala.
He will never
let you
have done great work.